Welcome back, and thanks for tuning in to episode 35 of LabPadre's SpaceX and Starbase weekly updates. Now let's dig in. Friday afternoon, the ship Quick Disconnect was detached from ship 24 while it sat on top of booster 7. A few hours later, the Quick Disconnect was extended, aligned, and reconnected to the ports on ship 24. In Florida, the three horizontal cryo tanks that were removed from Launch Complex 39A were seen leaving port heading to Brownsville. Early the next morning, Tug Crosby Skipper towed Just Read the Instructions out to sea in support of Hotbird 13G mission. Back at Starbase, two of SpaceX's self-propelled modular transporters were rolled down Highway 4 on their way to the launch site. SpaceX's LR-11000 crane picked up the ship load spreader and was attached to Ship 25, which was sitting on Test Stand A. That afternoon, the ship was disconnected from the crane after workers had performed inspections inside of its tanks. That night, in Mega Bay, crews were spotted installing Booster 9's chines, which will cover the COPVs as well as the batteries on the updated vehicle. At Historic Launch Complex 39A, on Sunday night, SpaceX rolled out their Falcon Heavy back to the horizontal assembly facility. In the hangar, crews later attached the Space Force's payload and the fairings to the center core of the rocket. Monday morning, at the Starbase launch site, Booster 8 was rolled across the landing pad and onto Highway 4. The vehicle was moved down the road before becoming the newest addition in the rocket garden. At Port Canaveral, Gator Cam spotted SpaceX support vessel Bob as it headed out to sea for the launch of the Hotbird 13G mission. That afternoon, SpaceX once again rolled out their Falcon Heavy back out of the horizontal assembly facility, this time with its payload fully integrated on the top of the soon-to-be-expended center core. Back at Starbase, a new round of testing was underway at the launch site. This time, Booster 7's LOX tank was partially loaded with cryogenics before detanking. Then, the ship Quick Disconnect was detached from the ship, and it was seen venting from multiple ports before reconnecting to the vehicle while still venting. Monday evening, SpaceX raised the USS F-44 mission's Falcon Heavy launch vehicle to vertical at Historic Launch Complex 39A in preparation for its launch the following day. Meanwhile, as Stage Zero was winding down from the day's test, both of our rover cams caught a lightning storm descending on Starbase. In the early hours of Tuesday morning, the Raptor maintenance platform was once again hoisted into position underneath the launch mount. Later that morning, the first Falcon Heavy in 3 years took off for the USS F-44 mission. Both side boosters later returned to touchdown at landing zones 1 and 2. Back at Starbase just a few hours later, Ship 27's Mid-8 stack moved from High Bay to Mid Bay, switching places with Ship 26's Mid-8 stack. Over at Test Stand A at the launch complex, Ship 25 was undergoing a fresh round of testing. During the test, both the oxygen and methane tanks were loaded with cryogenics before detanking from an apparent successful first cryoproof. On Wednesday, the road was once again closed as Ship 25 was subjected to its second straight day of cryogenics proof testing. Both tanks were eventually filled before detanking. Thursday morning, the Hotbird 13G launch lit up the night sky as Falcon 9 booster B-1067 lofted the telecommunications satellite towards geostationary orbit from Launch Complex 40. Rovercam caught the rapid progress being made erecting a new tent similar to the production tents at the Sanchez site. Down the road, the launch site was closed and cleared for another round of full stack testing. SpaceX started by partially filling both Booster 7 and Ship 24's methane tanks before detanking. Meanwhile, a ship transport stand was rolled out of High Bay and down Highway 4 towards the dome yard. Back at the launch site, SpaceX finished the day's full stack test by partially filling the LOX tanks on both vehicles before detanking once more. And finally for this week, just after midnight Friday morning, NASA once again rolled out their Space Launch System Artemis 1 rocket out of the Vehicle Assembly Building. The rocket returned to the VAB at the end of September to shelter from the hurricane. During its more than 5 week stay in the building, NASA performed various inspections and maintenance tasks, including battery swaps and working to troubleshoot the hydrogen leak experienced in September. With the vehicle having again safely arrived at the launch pad, crews will continue to prepare for the next launch attempt, currently scheduled for the 14th of November. And there you have it, another SpaceX and Starbase weekly update brought to you by LabPadre. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week. LabPadre out.